ISUPK.
Hey, salam, man. It's Priest Kevin Gondonhall with the ISUPK and the Commander Journey and Honor in California, man. To all blacks, Hispanics, and Native Indians, subscribe to this channel, man. You want true salvation? You're going to learn from the priests and prophets of the ISUPK, man. Subscribe to that channel. Hit that button, man. Understand with that? Salam.
We want no cowards in our camp, in our camp.
Matthew chapter 6 verse 9. We're going to read Matthew chapter 6 verse 9. This is going to be good for all you Christians who don't know how to pray. This is what you're taught to pray for, right? Go ahead.
This is Matthew chapter 6 verse 9. After this manner, therefore pray ye.
So Yahushua, a man you know as Jesus Christ, was teaching blacks, Hispanics, Native American Indians to pray. And he's saying, after this manner, meaning this way, is the way you should pray. This is how you should pray. Read for me. Go ahead.
Therefore pray ye, our Father which art in heaven, hallowed be thy name.
That's a very popular prayer. You understand? But if anybody understood the power of this prayer, what it actually means, you'd respect it more. You understand? It teaches us what to actually pray for. Our Father in heavens, hallowed be thy name. Go ahead.
Thy kingdom come.
Thy what?
Thy kingdom come.
Christ is teaching us to pray for God's kingdom to come. You understand? That's going to be our solution here, black man, Hispanic man. You understand? We have no leaders here. But what's a kingdom? A kingdom is a government. You understand? What does a government have? A king. A government has leaders. You understand? All you got to do to understand a government is look at America. They have a president. They have the Senate. They have all these different sections in the government to ensure that the people who it rules over, the people who it rules for, not us, the people who it rules for are happy. You understand? Well, read from the top one more time.
Good. Thy kingdom come.
Salah.
After this manner, therefore pray ye, our Father which art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come. Thy will be done.
Thy what?
Thy will be done.
Here's the important part. Watch this. Go ahead.
In earth.
Where?
In earth.
Go ahead.
As it is in heaven.
You know, the problem is the Christian church taught us that what happens on earth don't matter. You understand? The Christian church taught us what happened here doesn't matter. Why? Because if you're going to die, you're going to go to heaven. Let me tell you something, man. What happened here matters. You understand? What happened here matters to God. In fact, they tell us to pray for what? God's kingdom to come on earth. God's kingdom is coming on earth. And what's coming to earth? Judgment. You understand? When God's kingdom gets here, what's going to happen? Judgment's going to happen here on earth. You understand? Christians are taught not to care about George Floyd because he's in a better place now. You understand? Can you imagine looking at his children and telling them, don't worry about it, he's in a better place now. Instead of talking about judgment. When somebody you love is murdered in front of you, right on live on TV, it'd be very evil for me to tell you, don't worry about it, he's in a better place. What I should be telling you about is what God's going to do about the situation. You understand? Give me Daniel chapter 2 verse 44. Give me Daniel chapter 2 verse 44, and we're going to find out when God's kingdom come on earth, what's going to happen here on earth. You understand? We're going to find out. Take your time. Daniel chapter 2 verse 44. And the reason, and that whole system of going to heaven when we die is witchcraft. You understand? Because it forces you not to not care about what happens on earth. You understand? But this is what God said is going to happen on earth. Daniel chapter 2 verse 44. Go ahead.
It's the book of Daniel chapter 2 Verse 44. And in the days of these kings.
In the what?
The days of these kings.
The days of these kings. Which kings? The kings out here now. The Donald Trumps. You know? The Putins. All the kings that exist now. In the days of these kings, go ahead.
Shall the God of heaven set up a kingdom.
So in the days of those kings, in the latter part of the days, during this time, the God of heaven is going to set up a kingdom. Again, what's a kingdom? A government. You understand? Go ahead.
Which shall never be destroyed.
Which shall what?
Never be destroyed.
God is going to set up a kingdom on this earth that's never going to be destroyed. You understand? Many kingdoms have come and gone prior to this kingdom here. You had Egypt. You had Babylon. You had Assyria. You had Greece. You had Rome. You have so many different kingdoms that have come and gone in terms of rulership. You understand? But the God of heaven is going to set up a kingdom. Read from the top one more time.
God will come. Daniel 2, verse 44. And in the days of these kings shall the God of heaven set up a kingdom which shall never be destroyed.
A kingdom that will never be destroyed. Go ahead.
And the kingdom shall not be left to other people.
It shall what?
It shall not be left to other people.
What does it mean? This kingdom is going to belong to you, black man. It shall not be left to another people. Meaning it shall not belong to everybody else who's trying to hijack your protest. You understand? Go ahead.
But it shall break in pieces.
It shall what?
It shall break in pieces.
Go ahead.
And consume all these kingdoms.
It shall what?
It consume all these kingdoms.
God's kingdom is coming not to join. A lot of people think when Yahushua, the man you know is Jesus Christ, a lot of people think when he gets here, he's going to have the meeting with Donald Trump. That's what you think. You think his first stop is the White House. He's going to show up with a suit and tie with a red tie on his neck and sit down with Donald Trump and shake hands. You think that God is Black Panther, man. You've been taught that God is Black Panther when he's coming to have a meeting. You think when God gets here, he's going to the United Nations. And you're going to turn on your TV and say, okay, God is in the United Nations. We're safe now. That's not what's happening, bro. You understand? This is what's happening when God gets here. Read from the top one more time.
Okay. Daniel 2 and 44. And in the days of these kings shall the God of heaven set up a kingdom which shall never be destroyed, and the kingdom shall never be left to other people, but it shall break in pieces.
Shall what?
It shall break in pieces.
The Lord's coming to break things in pieces. He's coming to break this kingdom in pieces, man. Imagine you're here voting for, you're trying to decide who you should vote for, right? You're trying to decide if I should vote for Donald Trump or if I should vote for so-and-so and so-and-so. But God is coming to destroy it. You understand? God is not coming to join them. God is not coming to approve your votes. God is not coming to tell you, hey, you voted for Donald Trump, you did the right thing. Or you voted for whoever else, and you did the right thing. That's not what God's coming for. He's coming to break in pieces. Go ahead.
God will come. And consume all these kingdoms.
And what?
Consume all these kingdoms.
What does it mean to consume? What consumes? A fire. Fire consumes. God's coming to set fire on all these kingdoms, man. To destroy all these kingdoms. Why? Why would God come and destroy these kingdoms? Because what has happened to blacks, Hispanics, Native American Indians here in America is wrong. You understand? And he's coming to do judgment. And his judgment is to destroy these kingdoms. You understand? Go ahead.
And it shall stand forever.
It shall what?
Stand forever.
And God's kingdom will stand forever. You understand? God's kingdom is not going nowhere. You understand? And God's kingdom is coming to rescue you out of this slavery, man. Out of this poverty. You understand? America has taught you, let me tell you something, sidebar. America has taught black people that we're in the condition we're in because, you know, we put ourselves in that condition. That's not true. That's not true. Black people are in the condition they're in today because they had no leadership. You understand? Any people with no leadership will be destroyed. You understand? You are up for the taking. You're available to be robbed if you have no leadership. You understand? Give me Revelation chapter 13. You understand? And let me tell you something, man. Christ is not coming to make peace with these kingdoms. You understand? You know how your campaign, your leaders say, you know what, you vote for me, you know, I'm going to give you reparations. You vote for me, I'm going to do the civil rights movement. You vote for me, I'm going to give you loans. Everybody's trying to buy you. You understand? Nobody, let me tell you something. No leader in America has ever gone up and said, you vote for me, black man, I'm going to give you justice. what has happened to you here. You understand? They don't want justice. You understand? They want to give you money. They want to give you hope. They want to give you more churches, more drugs, more alcohol, and more slavery. That's what they want to give you. You understand? You understand? Anytime somebody's going to get something, it's a different nation. You understand? You understand? We were here before the Chinese. You understand? We supposed to have Negro Town. The Chinese got Chinatown. You understand? Everything that was promised to us, another nation got. Let me ask you, you know who benefited most after the Civil Rights Movement? You wanna know who benefited the most? White women. That's who benefited off that. You understand? Anytime something a plate is set for you, somebody else just comes and takes it. You understand? Anytime a plate is set for you, somebody just more powerful for you just comes and takes it. You understand? But this is what Christ has promised. The man you call Jesus Christ. This is his campaign speech. You understand? You want to hear? You want to know if you should want Christ to rule over you? This is what he promises. You understand? Read.
Verse 9. Come. Revelation 13, verse 9. If any man have an ear, let him hear.
This is his campaign right here, brother. You understand? This is what Christ is going to promise you. If you have an ear, listen to this. Hear this. Understand this. Go ahead. He that leadeth into captivity. Meaning, if you take a people and you lead them into slavery, you take a people by a chain and you put them in slavery for 400 years. You understand? He that leadeth into captivity. Go ahead.
Shall go into captivity.
What?
Shall go into captivity.
That's Christ's campaign, man. That's what Christ is promising you. Christ is telling you, you know what? They put you in chains, I'm going to put them in chains. You know what? And that sounds foreign to you. You never taught this in church. You understand? But that's how justice works. You understand? Do unto them as you like done unto you. You understand? That's in the Bible. So if you take a man, a family, a people, and put them in captivity, what do you think God is coming to do? God is coming to shake your hand. God is coming to understand why you did that. God is coming to pardon you. God is not coming to pardon anybody. Read one more time.
It's Revelations 13 and 10. He that leadeth into captivity shall go into captivity.
He that leadeth into captivity, you understand, shall go into captivity. Black man, let me tell you something, man. They may look at you as the worst person on earth. They may look at you as the one who's no good. Ain't no good black man. That's a popular term. You understand? You never heard, when you hear ain't no good, you never hear no other nation. You understand? You never hear anybody say, ain't no good Chinese man, ain't no good white man, ain't no good East Indian man. No. They say, ain't no good black man. You understand? But guess what? To God, you're good. You understand? Why are you good? Because you've never taken anybody into slavery. You understand? They're trying to make you look like you're the villain on the earth. Let me ask you a question, black man. How many people have you enslaved? Since you're the worst person on the earth. How many bombs have you dropped on people? You ever heard the term carpet bombing? You know what that is? Carpet bombing? Carpet bombing is where a plane flies over a village and drops bombs on every 6 square feet. It's like dropping bombs like a carpet. That's carpet bombs. How many people have you done that to? How much land have you stolen? Since you're the worst person on the earth. Since they've convinced us that we are the problem on the earth, I want to know, what crime have we committed? You understand? Besides being poor, besides being in need, besides having our plate taken from us. You understand? We black men, don't let nobody tell you you're the worst person on the earth. You ain't drive no planes into no buildings. You ain't bomb nobody. You ain't do no mass shootings. You understand? You ain't do no, you ain't say, you know what? I'm upset. I'm gonna go into Walgreens and shoot up random people. You ain't do that. You understand? Keep reading.
Okay. He that killeth with the sword.
Christ said, he that killeth with the sword. Meaning when you go into war and murder innocent people, this is the outcome. Keep reading.
Must be killed with the sword.
Must what?
Be killed with the sword.
You have to be killed with the sword. That's Christ's judgment. You understand? When he comes to earth as king, when Yahushua comes to earth as king, the man you call Jesus Christ, he's coming to put people in captivity. You understand? He's coming to kill people. You understand? Right now, you have little Mexican babies in cages. Right. You think Christ is coming to say, good job, America?
Right.
This is what you think is going to happen? When Christ coming, he sees these little babies in cages. When he sees black women on stripper poles, somebody's going to be held accountable.
Right.
right.
You understand? Where's these black people on drugs? Where's these sheep without a shepherd? Somebody's gonna have to be judged.
Right.
You understand? And America's gonna find out that they are not who they think they are. You understand? They are not the home of the free, the land of the free, the home of the brave. You understand? They're gonna find that out. They're gonna find out that they are an enemy to God, just like the Egyptians found out. You understand? If you want to understand what's happening here in America, you just gotta go back to the book of Exodus and understand what happened in Egypt. You understand? Understand what happened in Egypt and you understand what's gonna happen in America. Why? Because guess what? The slaves in Egypt are in America. And the God of the Israelites are the gods of the black people in America. So it's gonna be the same outcome. You understand? Give me, you got any more on that? Go ahead.
Here is the patience and the faith of the saints.
Read again.
Here is the patience and the faith of the saints.
Here is the patience. What's patience? It says, he said, he who leads into captivity shall go into captivity. He who kills with the sword must be killed with the sword. Here is the patience of the saints. What's patience? Somebody is waiting for this judgment. You understand? There's somebody who was murdered unjustly. That brother George Floyd, you understand, is waiting for the judgment. He's waiting for justice. You understand? And the Lord is not going to disappoint. You understand? The Lord is not going to disappoint. Give me Luke. You understand? Give me Luke chapter 19.
I didn't know she bent over. It must have been you.
Give me Luke chapter 19. Give me Luke chapter 19, verse 27.
The book of Luke, chapter 19, verse 27. But those my enemies.
This is Christ. This is Christ speaking. And this is specific to the Christian church who hates the message of Christ. Read it again.
But those mine enemies, which would not that I should reign over them, bring hither and slay them before me.
So everybody think Christ is coming to hug everybody. Christ is saying those his enemies, he's going to slay.
My whole life was trying to find something to follow. Had loyalty, every man tried to borrow. Felt pain and a lot of sorrow. Got betrayed, sold packs, I didn't even have my heart broke. Living confused, about to lose hope. Cops got me on the side of the road like a sideshow. Need an antidote before I croak. Now I'm setting fire, the rhythm man blues, call this guitar smoke. Rebel with no cause, trying to find direction. The world got me vexed, picked up a bad liquor habit that's hereditary from oppression. Felt like my life was on fire, trying to find an exit. Now look, 10 G's plus a good record. Sometimes a follower is a soldier, trying to find a good shepherd. Plus when you in hell, how do you excel? Wisdom the breath of life, I don't believe in fairy tale. Listen well to what I tell. No calling can cause pain, something that a rebel knows very well. Can't you tell I was sent from the Lord? Got a tongue like a two-edged sword. With